Okay, werewolf, you're up. Here we go. Oh, he's gonna get chomped. Oh, he's chomped in the mouth. Oh, whoa, he's done a backflip. And the Purosaurus T-Rex has won the fight. Welcome back to Animal Revolt Battle Simulator. We have a new update, and these are the creatures that I have made. Because in this update, they have added some more stuff to the unit creator. So this right here is a Brachiosaurus with 3 Titanoboa heads. Very strange. And by the way, I haven't seen any of these in action yet, so I have no idea what they're going to be like. And they're going up against some Spartan warriors and also archers. So moving on from this weird looking thing, we have a wyvern base with the demon's face and a Purosaurus tail. Man, Ops is getting very strange, that's for sure. And then next to that, we have the hellhound head, Purosaurus body, and the tail of the dinosaur I forget the name of. And then finally, we have this thing. This is a human with a Purosaurus face. I have no idea how that's going to attack. And finally, the last thing we have in this update is a flamethrower, which again, I haven't really seen in action. But before we check that out, let's see what these guys are capable of. So here we go. Oh, there goes the wyvern thing, picking some up. The wall has gone down. Oh, the Titanoboa thingy-majig. I don't know what it even is. Get the archers. Probably the only one that's tall enough. Oh, hang on a minute. Never mind. The wyvern got them. Jeez. Okay, so the hellhound should also still be able to spit fire. Right, we have one left. Oh, the Titanoboa just can't reach. So close. Come on. Dude, you are so screwed. Here comes the demon wyvern thing. Oh, and he is gone. The weird creatures have won the fight. Now, to test out the new flamethrower, I'm going to use Goru here and attach the flamethrowers, I think, maybe like here. Let's leave out one and let's see how much damage they do. They cost $80 each, so they're not too expensive compared to some of the other stuff. And now let's see how much damage they do. Oh, well, that seems very powerful. Okay, can it knock down the wall, though? Yes, it can. Oh, what? That was so easy. He's won just like that. So these flamethrowers will be really good for taking down buildings, that's for sure. So it's been a little while since I've been on the grid map here, but I'm here for good reason, because I want to create a new unit using some of the new stuff in the update. And I want to make it a mix between like a Purosaurus and a T-Rex. So it should look pretty terrifying. So let's go ahead and get started. I really should be using all the new stuff that we have, you know, some of the new infernal heads and stuff like that. But I just wanted to make something scary looking and something powerful. So let's head over to animal base, then select the T-Rex. I also might scale it up a little bit and also change some of the stats. Let's go for HP multiplier 2 and attack multiplier also 2. And actually, you know what? We won't bother scaling up. We'll leave it as it is. It should be enough, I reckon. Now, the next thing I'm going to add is the T-Rex body. So like I said, we are primarily sticking to the Purosaurus here and T-Rex, but mostly T-Rex, as you can probably tell. Unless, what if I change the tail to a Purosaurus tail? That could definitely look interesting. Then scale up 1.4. How does that look? I mean, doesn't look too bad, I guess. Yeah, you know what? I'm sticking with it. And now for the head. Purosaurus. I mean, we could have a Titanoboa. How weird would that look? Yes. Very, very weird. Let's not have that. Let's just stick with the Purosaurus. Oh man, that is, hang on a minute. Let me just scale up to 5. All right, we are not doing that, but I do actually want to quickly see it in action. Okay, werewolf, you're up. Here we go. Oh, he's gonna get chomped. Oh, he's chomped in the mouth. Oh, whoa, he's done a backflip. And the Purosaurus T-Rex has won the fight. All right, well, that was really weird to see that in action. Let's just go ahead, remove it, and get the actual head in. Yeah, this thing should be pretty incredible when it's done. I'm hoping it's gonna look really cool. Okay, let's scale up maybe 1.4 again. How does that look? Maybe a little bit less than that. 1.2. Yeah, I reckon that should do the trick. Now, I'm not a big fan of how the T-Rex only has 2 legs. I kind of want this creature to look like it has 4 legs, but instead I'm using claws. So technically it is still 2. And then I'm just going to go ahead and scale it up like this. Okay, so it doesn't really look like extra legs, but we're going to stick with it anyway, because I reckon these claws could do quite a bit of damage. So that is now pretty much our unit created in terms of how it's going to look. But now we need to add armor and probably some extra spikes to do some more damage. So the base animal is complete. Maybe I'll add some more to it soon, but let's head over to armor and let's go for this one here. I think this should look pretty good somewhere around here. We can also cover up some of the parts that look bad. You can see where it's, you know, not quite attached correctly there. Ooh, yeah, that looks cool. So using the helmet here, I've given him some spikes. It looks, actually looks really good, to be honest. I mean, it doesn't look like a helmet anymore, but that's fine. So let's go ahead and give this guy some extra bone spikes. I reckon we should have them going all the way down the body, kind of all over the place, would look pretty cool. You know, in different directions. It doesn't have to be symmetrical, really. Just kind of like this, I think. So far, this creature is looking pretty good. I've also given him some extra spikes on the front here. Hopefully, that'll do just a bit more damage when he chomps down on the enemies. So the next thing I'm going to do is actually add some spikes to his elbow here. So let's go 1.4 and then scale it down 1.3 and keep going like that. Okay, that looks pretty cool. Now we have to do the same on the other side. So starting off with 1.4, 1.3, 1.2. And how many did we have on the other side? Was that right?
I think so.
Yeah, it's probably not totally symmetrical, but you know what? It's okay. Well, I have been working on this unit for a little while now, and I present to you... Well, actually, I don't have a name for it yet. So that's where you guys come in, because I need you all to give me a name for this creation right here. The best name will win. So if you see a name you like, make sure you like it. And hopefully I'll have a better chance of seeing it. But let's finally see what it is like in action. So first up, we are going up against King Kung. Now, I've done no test fights with this yet, so I have no idea what it's going to be like. Hopefully, everything works out okay and, you know, it doesn't freak out and stuff. But yeah, we have a flamethrower on it. We actually have two flamethrowers on it, one on each side. That one's actually very wonky, so I might need to change that. But he also has green glowing eyes, spikes everywhere, and also nice sparkle effects, which you're about to see. Start the battle! Here we go! Please, come on, work. Yes! Oh! He's been impaled by the spikes on the mouth. Oh! No way. Victory just like that. King Kung didn't stand a chance. This guy is a beast! So, he took down King Kung with ease. Let's see if he can take down Goru, a very powerful unit. Here we go, come on. Oh! Oh, there go the flamethrowers! Come on! He looks so cool! Oh, he's spinning! Wait, does he do the spinning attack because he has the Purosaurus head? No way. This is so cool. I actually love this creation right here. Yes, Goru is down. How much health did he take? Ooh, almost halfway. Goru did pretty good, but it just wasn't enough. What about the Scourge unit? The Scourge is very strong, so this should be an interesting fight. I still don't think it will be able to take down my creation, but I guess we're about to find out. All right, here we go. Scourge, get ready to die. Here come the initial spikes, but that's fine. This guy has basically made our spikes. That won't bother him. Ooh, big punch from the Scourge unit. Oh no. Purosaurus, do the spinning attack. Come on. Yeah, those flamethrowers are very powerful. That's going to do a lot of damage. And he has won. This next fight could be the toughest one yet. So there's actually a bunch of enemies in the bushes over there. So let's go ahead and reveal them. It is the saltwater crocodile. And there's quite a lot of them. Oh, he's picked one up. Okay, it's an ambush. Surely we're not going to win this fight. There's way too many of them. Oh, that one just got messed up. This Purosaurus tail is quite useful, to be fair. Just swing enemies around if they try to latch on. Oh, yes. Just swing them about. That's it. He's done it. Yes. The nameless unit is victorious. How much health? Wait, is that it? I thought this would be a tough battle. Never mind. Next up, we have the Hydra. So I still feel like my unit will win this one with the upgraded stats, but it will be a little bit difficult with the five heads. Okay, so they are pushing us back right now. I think one of the heads is already dead. Wait, no, they're all dead. Victory. Again, not much health has been taken off. Next up, we have an army of snakes. That is a lot of Titanoboas and also Anacondas. Look at them moving in. Oh, now the unit is struggling. There's no way he is winning this battle. They're just surrounding him right now. Oh, look at that. Oh, no. Need to get out of there, buddy. Pull back. Too many snakes. Probably the fire that's doing all the damage right now with the flamethrowers. Come on, kill the Titanoboas. I think most of the Anacondas are now dead, swinging about all over the place. Let's check out the health. Oh, he's lost a lot of health, and there's still quite a few of them alive. I'm a little bit worried about this one. Only a couple more Anacondas alive now. Oh, this one's stuck in the fence. And now he is also dead. Whee! That's what it looks like. Whee! So yeah, by the looks of it, No unit alone can actually take down this guy. I'm sure modified ones would be able to. But yeah, this guy is awesome. I'm on a new map now, and this map is called Will It Blend. This is from the workshop, and I want to see if the unit I just created can blend. So let's find out. Start the battle. Oh, he looks a little confused. He's spinning around. It's because he wants to go for the A block. Oh, down he goes. And the answer is, it will blend. Oh. Finally, he's been defeated. But, you know, took a blender to kill him. Oh, he's getting messed up. I mean, to be fair, the block has been upgraded, as you can see. So that's pretty why it died so quickly. I wonder if the army killer will blend. Let's find out, shall we? Down he goes. Oh, he's too heavy. He weighs too much. So, yeah, the answer to that is he will not blend. In fact, I think he actually might kill the blender itself. Right, let's find something else to blend. I know. What about a bunch of werewolves? This should work. Yes. Fall and blend. Do we have any survivors? There's one on the block right now. No, get off. Oh, no. They're attacking. Wait, where's he going? Looks like we have no survivors, really. Ooh. Okay, are they dead? Nope, one left. Oh, now he's dead. Now, it wouldn't be an OBS video without Godzilla. So, Godzilla, let's see if you can survive the blender. Down you go. Whoa. Oh, he's fallen in. Yes. Oh, he's too fat again. He weighs too much, so it's not spinning anymore. Godzilla might actually be able to take down the blender, though. Let me check on the health. Oh, it has lost a bit of health. Godzilla could be the first unit today to destroy the contraption. Although it looks like it could take a long time. So for that reason, let's go ahead and end this one. So I feel like I haven't really played around with the new flamethrowers that much. So I'm going to send in a wyvern, well, a custom wyvern, to hopefully destroy this city right here. Okay, here we go. There goes the wyvern. Flamethrowers are activated now. Not too much damage so far. Oh, there we go. That's one tower destroyed. See, the issue is, I think when the wyvern picks up the people, I think the flamethrowers then activate, which means they are burning while in the air. Right, it's coming around. Swooping in. There we go. Yep, see? Burnt. Just smashed right through that building. He's coming around. Who's he going to claim? Oh, he's going for the guy in the building. And now I'm guessing he's dead. Oh, it's making it look so easy. Yep, those flamethrowers are very powerful. Oh, this building looks like it's going to go down. Yep, it's falling. Oh, and he survived though. So that's good. Uh-oh, this building is screwed. Oh, this is so cool. So yeah, this update, it was a pretty small one in comparison to what we've had before. You know, it was mainly focused on the unit creator. However, I have some good news. In about 3 weeks' time, we should have another update, but the next update should be a big one according to the developers. So make sure you keep an eye out for another Animal Revolt Battle Simulator video in about 3 weeks. I don't know what the update is going to include, I am excited for it. But anyway, on that note, I'm going to go ahead and end this one right here. There's another video on the top right, so make sure you go ahead and check that out. Also, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll hopefully see you in that video right there. Goodbye!